Lord have mercy. Check it out. How can you say you love God? People got God rolling all their lips. God this and God that. And then the Bible said, you say you love God and you got to love the one that's begotten. That's Jesus. You got to love Jesus. My God, people say, I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Because he first loved me. And then you mention the baptism in Jesus' name. And all of a sudden, you don't love him so much. All of a sudden, you got a problem. But I can't notice on you today. My God, the only way you can go to heaven, the only way you're going to go back with Jesus, you got to repent and be baptized in that same Jesus' name that you say you love so much. My God, and be filled with the Holy Ghost and live a holy life. And my God, you'll go back with him when he come and take the church out of the world. My God, love go beyond than talking. Love has to be shown. Hallelujah, God. For the Bible said God so loved the world that he gave something. His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in it should not perish but have everlasting life. Come on, jump up real quick and give God a praise. Go on, read verse 2.
Verse 2. By this we know
that we by this we know what?
That we love the children of God.
Why?
When we love God and keep his commandments.
How in the world can you say you love each other? You're a Christian. You're Christ-like. How can you say you're a Christian when you don't love God's creation, his people? Huh? A new commandment that you love one another. Anybody that hates, chalk it up. They're not of God. They're of the devil. Huh? Christian is not what you say. Christian is what you live. Huh? Christian is what you live. Character. People love to talk about character. Let me inject some character. Our president got character. This man been called everything on the planet. But he's so smooth. He got so much character, he won't even call your name back. That's character, baby. Huh? Character is showing up non-character. Huh? And people get mad when they call you everything and you don't fight them back. They get furious. Huh? But that's a real man. That's a real champion. You will never see this, but keep up the good work, Mr. President. Keep it up. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Y'all ain't saying that. Thank you. Thank you. Let your character always rise above the haters. Thank you. Hate ain't never got nobody nowhere. Hate gets you destruction. That's all. Hate destroy you. And you can see hate all on people's face. Try to act Christian, but see hate is radiating from you. Hallelujah, because you don't have the right spirit. You got the wrong spirit. My God, you need to say like David, create in me a clean heart and renew the right spirit within me. My God, people got a bad spirit. That's why the world is in the shape it's in. People got a bad spirit. Hallelujah, Christendom got a bad spirit and calling it God. How in the world can you associate God with hate? God identified with one thing, that's love. Hallelujah. The fruit of the Spirit. Hallelujah. God's associated with that. Come on, give him praise in his place.
Hallelujah.
Come on, read.
Verse 3. For this is the love of God.
What?
That we keep his commandments.
How can we say we love God and don't keep his commandments? Huh? The Bible said the Lord commanded and commanded man everywhere to repent. How can a person love God and don't do what he says? Somebody had an answer. I need an answer to that one. Huh? How can you love the eternal God? The Bible said, for this is the love of God. That we keep his commandments, and his commandments are not grievous. You can disagree, but you don't supposed to hate. Yeah, you can disagree. Disagreement is normal. Ain't no sin to disagree with you. Ain't no sin to disagree. The sin is to hate. To inject hate into it. Well, y'all ain't saying that. Come on, read.
verse 4. Whosoever is born of God,
do what?
Overcometh the world.
Overcometh! I can't read.
And this is the victory.
For whosoever is born of God, do what?
Overcometh the world.
Overcometh the world. Overcometh. When you're born of God, listen, you put down every challenge. You're going to be challenged spiritually as long as you live on this earth. Satan's going to always launch some type of an attack against you. But we overcome the wicked one. Why? We are in God. We are born of God. We are born of a new spirit. We have a spirit that has power. That's how you overcome. You overcome by strength, power. And that is by the Holy Ghost. That's why Paul said, I can do all things through Christ. Oh, y'all ain't with me. That strengthened me. You can't win this battle on your own. You can't win this battle in the flesh. You don't have strength in the carnal mind to fight an enemy you can't see. You got to have the Holy Ghost. But the Bible said the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, not God, but mighty through God. The pulling down of strongholds. You can't fight an invisible enemy in your flesh. We must rely on the eternal God. His name is Jesus. Hallelujah. That's why he said, I'll give you
challenge that. No, you don't. If you believe